Hi, welcome to AV Academy. Today we're going to look at echo cancellation, why we need it, and how it works. One of the most common things in a conference audio system is a connection for video conferencing. In general, you'll have a video conferencing codec, and that will have one audio input and one audio output. In a standard meeting room, you'll get audio from the far end and play this out of your room loudspeakers. In turn, you'll send a mix of your room microphones to the far end. Now this seems straightforward enough so far, except if we did just that, it would sound awful. Why? Well, let's look at the journey the audio is taking. When the audio from the far end comes out of the loudspeakers in your room, you hear it through your ears, which is fine, but that sound also gets picked up by your room microphones. And this sound in turn gets sent back to the far end and comes out of their loudspeakers and goes into their microphones and back again. Because the video conferencing link has a small time delay, this means that you'll get an echo of the sound bouncing back and forth, back and forth. And this is why echo cancellation was invented. It's used everywhere, on our smartphones, especially in loudspeaker mode, and systems like Skype use it too. It gets more complicated in the AV world because we may have a number of microphones in our conference room. For each microphone, you need a separate echo cancellation input into your signal processor. And the reason being is that each mic will be in a different location and will pick up a slightly different sound. The echo cancellation circuitry examines the sound going into the microphone and compares it with the sound coming from the far end. It then cancels out the sound that it detects in both signals, as that can only be the sound from the far end. This means only the sound of the person speaking into the microphone is mixed with the other microphones and sent to the far end. The microphones in the system at the far end also need echo cancellation. So that's all we have in this session. If you want to learn more about audio, please check out our Audio Academy training course.